You never know what you're going to find inside a gob of spit. If you're lucky, it might be the nymph of a common meadow insect called a spittlebug.
One of the advantages of not mowing your lawn is that you get spittlebugs right on your own lawn. Here's a spittlebug.
Most people use the word bug to apply to all insects, but technically, bugs are their own distinct taxonomic group. You can tell bugs apart from beetles because bugs have sucking rather than chewing mouth parts. And juvenile bugs look like miniature wingless adults, in contrast to caterpillars or the grub-like larvae of flies.
What do you think is inside here?
Spittlebugs are harmless little insects. Their mouth parts are kind of like a drinking straw, and they stab the straw into the plant and intercept the fluids inside the plant. Plants don't have a lot of nitrogen in their sap, so they have to suck a lot of the sap in order to get enough nitrogen to make the proteins that they need. And what do you do with all that extra sap? Well, they let it go right out the backside.
So the good news is that spittlebug spit is not really spit. Instead, it's an anal excretion that nymphs mix with mucus, froth with air bubbles, and spread over their bodies using their legs. Female spittlebugs lay eggs in the fall. The nymphs hatch in the spring, crawl up a plant, and create their first spittle mass. Often, you'll find more than one spittlebug in the same mass. Although that means that they compete for food, collectively they can produce more spit.
And here's a case where producing lots of spit is an advantage because it protects them from small parasitic wasps and other predators.
Look, Adrian, that's spittle coming out of his home in the spit.